still dancing with two left feet. I can get it. I can get it. Yeah. Now I'm still dancing with two left feet. Yeah. But with a little help, I can move on beat. Now I can moonwalk in two socks and groove all week. But I can't seem to two step. I lose my feet. Now I can shake it. I can shimmy. I can shuffle. I can gritty.
You gritty?
I can gritty. It just don't look that pretty. And I can do this little walk too. It goes like this. It goes toe, 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 cross. Yeah, that's it.
Tell me, baby, what you mean by that?
Never move, I just do it through the music. Make the crowd just to check on the acoustics. I can never lose, I ain't never get a goose egg. But I'm still, I fly. Hit a groove with a two-step. Yes,
yeah,
she know I'm going to get it there.
The way she move her body,
yeah, she know just what she doing.
She
here.
Don't mess with anybody,
nah. Not a single person here. Whoa, got a bill, baby, why you bring your person here? Keep it on the low, talk to me, yeah. If you wanna go, walk to me, yeah. Yeah, so let's shimmy, 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 yeah. Back it up slow, like.
Tell me, baby, what you mean by that? Huh? They don't even got it, it just seems like that. Where you think you're going with them jeans like that? And start a little fire, gasoline on that. My boo, my boo, my boo, my boo, my boo, my boo.
Y'all already know it be the boy Young Gordon, and you rockin' with Tape Money Promotion. Hey, Tape Money Promotion. Give him that new shit, no fool shit. Oh, yeah. Let's go.
DJ Nico Lito.
didn't really take 100 years to get to 21. It didn't take a whole case of beer to have a little fun. And if I don't need gasoline and a black cat to get lit, no. But to us it did. That first kiss didn't really get you higher than the moon. And taking hits off cigarettes didn't really make you cool. That first check from that first job don't really make you rich, no. But to us it did. Our drugs didn't really go 200 miles an hour. That small town we
Show a screen where it says coming soon and a countdown.
Looks like a badass.
Nobody ain't a video baby.
EA Sports, within the game. That was the perfect call out there.
With a glass of wine and you taking a sip. Every word that you're saying is another step to my reputation, and I can't take it anymore. But you've opened that door. Yeah, there's two sides to every breakup. One's a lie and one's the truth. One of them went down and one was made up. But in the end, we both lose. Why can't we meet? If you quit telling lies about me,
happened back in 2003. Have a look at a link. Lincoln Financial Field, where 70,000 are rocking and ready to go in Philadelphia. Tonight, it's the Sunday night opener for the new NFL season between the Atlanta Falcons and the Philadelphia Eagles. In a marquee game of the weekend, off we go on a Sunday night on EA Sports. Wishing Adam again. That's not how you want to start the game.
Not at all, because not only do you give up the penalty and the field position, but it just kills the momentum of your team as you start a game.
Timeout defensively by the Falcons. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They'll start by running the option to the right. Good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line. Give them 15 yards to start their first drive of the game. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that, and here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game, and all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
Hurts going to keep it again, and this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
And if you like defensive football, focus on the defensive end on this play. He does everything exactly right. Reads the play and makes sure he spills it for a small gain.
Okay, break. My bad habits lead to
throw caught by Evans out wide. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And it'll leave him with 3rd and a full yard to go. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Gun, they'll try to run it. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. They're going on 4th down with Hurts. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The Eagles unable to convert there on 4th. And this defense holds on the Knights' opening drive. And 10 here as Ritter gets him ready at the 36-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. 2nd and 6. Set up a throw. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. 3rd down.
Not a great start dropping his first target, but let's face it, this won't be his last chance because he'll get opportunities to make up for without bench throughout this game. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And complete to Drake London. And he's going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. To the line of scrimmage. In fact, he's going to lose 4 yards. On second down, Covington. And a lot of talent on this Eagle defense, and you've seen it on these last two plays, both losses. Send the slot in motion left. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Anytime he reads bad cover, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they're up to the challenge.
On fourth down, Bradley Pinion on to punt for the Falcons. Hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense came through, was able to hold them without any points.
I would agree with you, partner. A little bit of a lucky break indeed, but you know what they say to us? No luck, just pure skill. We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
Well, I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now offensively if they get in that fourth down spot again.
Yeah, one would think so, but maybe because they held it, they might go for it again.
And this is going to be an Eagles first down as he's got this up to about the 34-yard line.
And this is just a little touchback. The center receiver in motion just kind of tap it forward to him. Now, it doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down, a nice, consistent game.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. Right about 20 yards on the pickup. And officially, they'll say it's going to go for 19. Well, I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react. Even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL, they're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point. And a lot of times, these players, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it. Receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line.
Cray, Ray, J, H, A, H, A, H, A, laughing all the way to the bank. Hey, spray, yo,
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. There at a first down.
They're getting ready to go to work now. Prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot. Picked up nice yardage, didn't it?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. Now a first carry for their fullback. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. You get in my way, I'm gonna feed you to the monster. I know you're doing the day, but at night turn to a monster. When the moon shines like an ice road trucker. Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. That's caught, Waddle on the left side. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18th yard line.
They were right on the precipice. Points were available. All they had to do was just fall forward, and they were going to put them up on the board instead. A long drive ends in heartbreak, and a melancholy trip back to the drawing board. I like it when to go a little bit lyrical for you.
Beginning on the ground with Patterson. Give the tackle to Hassan Reddick. We talked about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try to fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play. With a catchy jiggle on stack chips, you better got a half feet.
Fill him with the venom and eliminate him. Otherwise, I'm intimate. I don't want to hurt him, but I did him in a fit of rage. I'm murdering again. Nobody will have been a fit. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Deep in their own territory. They look to throw. As he throws there, incomplete.
They're giving him some different looks here defensively. They're only going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. A big third down coming up. He's hoping he's got a play dialed up. They can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Man, stop. Look what I'm planning.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. They'll set up to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. 30, past the 20. Touchdown, Falcons. Points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Koo able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Short kick taken right at the 20. Swift is hooked and he crushes it up. And the Falcons grab it. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
As that ball got away from him, and he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain, and he knew what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Take care of the ball.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Running back going through the line. Quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time. Wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
And some space here. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Yeah. Chip? Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Touchdown, Falcons! Drake London, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Falcons have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. And now, of course, all scoring plays are reviewed, and I think they're going to take an extra long look at this one. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point by Crew, up and good, and it's now 14-0. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And he'll get credit for putting him inside the 20 as the fair catch is made right at about the 19-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points. But then it's a foot race. And he's going to get this down inside the 40 before he's finally ridden out of bounds. A big play there for Philly. 45 yards.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
18 Rattler.
Hurts. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack.
So they'll accept that penalty, and that'll, of course, move the football up the field.
Down inside the 30. Play action. Here's Hurts. This is caught by Evans. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 15-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're starting to put some space here. In the first quarter, they didn't look so hot offensively. This second quarter, though, they've looked really good.
They jumped in the saddle in a big way now, and now they're in full gallop. I mean, before, kind of cantering around a little bit, right, trying to feel their way, not getting done what they wanted to. But somehow they put it together with play calling, execution, and now there's a pretty big gap.
And they'll look to make that gap even bigger here. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. Running the counter, Patterson, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. to throw. Throw out right, taken in by Patterson. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front. Defensive end, defensive tackle.
Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. The safety, Terrell Edmonds, picks it. And the Eagles are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. That, Charles, the first interception he's thrown here in year number two.
And I know it's just the first one, but didn't it feel like what we saw from him last year was plagued by this type of a play? And they thought that, you know, over the offseason, going into a second season, some of that would go away. Thus far, it still looks a lot like his rookie year.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half.
I think the defense surprised them there with that blitz on first down, but give it credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage. Well done.
To throw again on second down. Hurts. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles. Tough spot here. Third and long. Back to throw here. He completes it to Evans. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They do get 12, but they'll be marked short. And that leads to a fourth down. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. So we've reached halftime here in our initial Sunday night telecast of the new season. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! This patience of mine is thinner than twine is winner. Welcome back, Charles and I settled in the booth ready for quarter number three. Defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. They'll drop to throw. Another completion right back to Patterson. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six. Cooper, the man in motion right. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. They'll look to throw again. And he's going to be hit and taken down. And the Eagles will have solid field position here as they take over at the 45-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positive moving forward.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Here's Hurts to throw. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Eagles. And that looked almost to be a case of, you know, quarterback saying, hey, I'm going to throw this as far as I can and hope you run under it. Mission accomplished.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield. And you know, everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
And you can see in the next-gen stats, that one 62 yards in the air. In motion left is a running back. Hurts will throw. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Way up at the 23. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. And this will be a Falcons first down as good running gets him to about the 44.
You heard me say, don't nobody want none. Nobody want none. In the midst of the fight, everybody want guns, so I go. And it been that way within this spring of disaster. When I'm ripping, I'm flipping a bastard. I'm a pastor when I go faster.
On first down, going back to Patterson. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On second down now, Covington. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll go to the air here on third and two.
And bring up fourth down. Go with the hardest starter. Crap, if they want to get slapped, you don't want to see me snap bear trap in the forest. Sorry, no. Somebody better call police. I get down to the church house, call a priest. Consider praying, take a chance when in the studio, when you're with a Ouija board, and when they call the beast. So you talk a sake, Mobu, that means go do not. I'm sorry, Papa, I'm too bold to hop on Mobu. So you talk a sake, Mobu, that means go do not. I'm sorry, Papa, I'm too bold to hop on. Give me the mic, I'm gonna finish it in a minute. Everybody gonna wanna see me win in front of beginning. Even when I was dreaming and was sinning, I was already chopping the beginning. Living for minutes, now they wanna try to copy the flow and copy the image, but I never let my foot up for the middle for a minute. So what they got to look to throw here. Looking middle, that's complete. And he is gonna have a Falcons first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. They're able to keep the drive alive. 7 yards that time, but the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. Let's talk about it. You're singing like mumble rapping all kinds of crap, but let's talk about it. You're singing in a big mode and that quick flow, but let's talk about it.
So this offense able to convert on fourth. They got a fresh set of downs here, first and 10. They run the counter, Covington. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2. 1 quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
when I'm in that lab. Call me Uncle Festivus, immortal. I be rolling to your Esmeralda. Get dancing in my DM like she Esmeralda. Just playing, I tell her stop before your man get jealous, girl. Cause I can't be your man, baby, you got your own fella. Don't work in demolition, I am not a home wrecker. I'm second day, like player, a red microphone checker. And the only way to take my place is if they clone truck. Chips.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. They'll keep it on the ground. Covington. And he stopped immediately there. The offense on third down tonight. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This time it's 3rd and 3. Looking to throw. He'll get this to his tight end. It's Jonnu Smith. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. They'll run on first down. Covington. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4. At this stage of the game, with the score where it is, the key here is staying bounds, and he did just that. Not by a huge margin, but he stayed in.
And those come up in what we like to call winning edge meetings. The things that you have to do, late game situations, kicking situations, doesn't matter what it is, the things you have to do to win a game, and that comes up in that meeting, and you practice it, you got to be happy to see it executed, being able to stay in bounds before the clock. Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means it might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone. But it's incomplete. So decision time now, because a field goal keeps it a one-score game. What are you thinking?
Well, I'm looking at the down and distance, and that's where the issue comes in. It's not short enough that it's a no-brainer and you go for it. You have to analyze this one. To me, you take the field goal, take the points. I don't think you want to risk coming away with nothing.
He'll look to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Eagles defense able to hold. So that's a decision that could loom pretty large here. They go for it on fourth down, but come up empty.
But I actually like the call. And the reason? It shows me a head coach has faith in his team overall. First on the offensive side, thinking they can pick it up. But also knowing that he has faith in his defense, that if they don't, they'll go out there and stop him. I like the confidence he showed.
That's a gain of 4 as we slip inside of 4 minutes left in regulation.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, okay, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz it? Do I need to pressure it? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
And no pitch there, and no chance either, as he's brought down behind the line of scrimmage. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Throwing is Hurts. And that is incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people with bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Oh, that's going to be across the line. It's intercepted. Picked up by Richie Grant. And the Falcons are going to take possession of the football.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Under pressure, and down he goes. They sack it back at the 36. Ritter and the Falcons need an answer and a big play here on third and long following the sack. They have pressure coming, and they got it once again. Hassan Reddick, two plays in a row now that he has gotten in there for the sack, and it brings up fourth down. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning.
On the set.
They'll bring the tight end in motion right. They're going to look to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. A big opportunity to tie it with three and take the lead with a touchdown. Their defense definitely did their part with that pivotal fourth down stop. And now a timeout taken here defensively with 2:07 remaining. So they'll also have the stop coming up at the two-minute warning. Signs when they're so loud and clear. Lately I'm drowning my pain with a bottle and beer. From the 47, it's second and 5. No matter what I take, I feel the same. I've been down by the and they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he will get enough for a first down, and that will lead us to the two-minute warning. 48 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. What an opening weekend it's been already. Could the best finish be coming here on Sunday night? We'll find out as we come up on a first and 10. And it's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down second and right of the yard.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with second and a yard. Handoff out of the gun. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side, and he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Second and 2. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And they're knocking on the door now. As a good run there, going to take this to about the 10-yard line. 11 yards there, first down.
Well, they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. He's back to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute. Charles, what a big
drive late in the fourth quarter to take this lead.
And normally you're really excited if your offense has the ball late in the game. I think this crew is really excited to have their defense go back out there because they haven't surrendered a point in the fourth quarter yet. They've helped make this comeback possible with their defensive play. Now they get a chance to finish this game off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They had a drive that stalled out last time. Whitfield on fourth, didn't get it. How does that translate here? I would imagine momentum with the defense.
Definitely with the defense, because anytime anyone goes for that fourth down, that's telling you as a defense that you can't stop us. We don't think that you can. And when you actually do, that may put a little dent in the confidence of the offense the next time they hit the field.
Yeah, we'll see if they can bring that pride to the offense this go around. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's second and a yard from the 34. He'll look to throw. Took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there. But he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's thrown it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions. And that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well.
And now the third down, throw incomplete as well.
Remember, they've got one chance left to keep this one going. And I think for you and me, let's think along with their offensive coordinator now. Have to think back, cycle through every play of this contest, and remember what's worked and what hasn't. Because right here, he needs the best play of the game in order to keep this one alive.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Eagles are likely going to win it. The Eagles in the victory formation as they take a knee. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ball game. And they will take a knee here.